Okay, it's the last Thursday of the month, which means it's time for another Shroud of the Avatar release. I'm doing my usual what's new video, and the first thing to notice is this change in terminology here. Early access. So we've done away with pre-alpha and alpha and beta, and now we're early access. So I'm guessing that just means we've launched into early access. There's a long explanation of exactly what's going on the post that announced this this release. It's, you know, it doesn't really make a lot of difference, I would have said. It's what can we go for? Braids, bun, mohawk, bob. Go for ponytail this release. Let's see. Him with blue eyes. Let's go big. That's slightly anime look. Now, I'm not going to check now whether they've still got the old book where the mouse pointer disappears if you right click on the thing to move around, because that will just delay everything. I don't know that I want to. Do I want to adjust anything here? What does the nose tip shape do? I'll leave that where it is. What does that one do? We'll do that. Minimal adjustments we'll go for. Mouth. Let's go for just a little bit bigger. There we go. What's this one? Jaw. Oh, I can't be bothered running that. Let's create the character. So I quite often skip over that particular bit and just start on the Isle of Storms. But in this release there has been some new stuff to do with what pledge rewards you get. I'm not sure where that fits in yet. We'll probably come to it later on. But basically, up until now, if you... Ooh, interesting. It's reset all my stuff. Let's get that back over there. Let's get that back down here. I'll not change what the tabs do at the minute. Let's talk to the mysterious woman. Interesting graphical defects. I'm presuming that's shaders and stuff. I'm not going to read the help. Let's get rid of it. Guide. Oh, it's quite disturbing, isn't it? I'm in conversation. Good. I don't want to get rid of all the hints, because there might be something in them that's important. Now, there has been a load of performance improvements in this release, including upgrade of Unity to the version that allows for multi-threaded OpenGL, which may explain what we're currently seeing here. Truth. Love. Truth. Ah, so there's some interesting stuff there. It tells you actually what you've chosen now, look. It may have done that before, but I never got to see it. So yeah, there should be a lot of performance improvements if it doesn't give you a headache, which is what it looks like I might be doing at the minute. It is quite an interesting effect, isn't it? It's kind of hard to believe that they tested this on Linux at all, really, given the state of it. But anyway, let's carry on. So yeah, I was saying that into the rift, blah 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 blah. Let's go. I was saying that so at particular pleasure levels you get access to an indestructible artisan tool. And in all the past releases, every player that's at that level has just received all of the artisan tools and you just got to use them. In this release they've implemented the bit where you only get one of them. I'm not entirely sure how they've implemented it. I'm going in blind, so to speak. It's exciting, eh? But we shall see. Now clearly, in case you hadn't noticed, there's been a full wipe for everybody. But this is the second last full wipe. The next full wipe will be in July, and that will be the last one before... this is a bit less glitchy. Sword in the road. Let's pick up the sword first, shall we? I have the sword. Yeah, so there'll be one release. There'll be a wipe. There'll be a wipe in July. Salvage. I'm just going to basically go through this. Alright. So he wants something better for the dagger. There will be a full wipe in July, but that will be... let's just type English, shall we? Goodbye! That wipe will be the last one before the launch of episode 1. They don't want to describe what's happening in July as a launch. They, you know... This is where that all that early access terminology comes in. Winter mute of cough. Fingers. Bargains. Story. Alright, yes. So, goodbye. We need to do this quest. Yeah, so the new terminology is, it just seems smoother, doesn't it? Performance-wise. Almost a little jumpy. Anyway, yes. It's not a launch. The launch will be when episode 1 is released. Most of the basic story will be in place, though, for that release after the first wipe. The reason why we're not going straight into launch is that all the pledge reward people get to select their housing plots before the full launch, and they will use that to then determine how many extra houses they need to put in to be bought in game after the launch. But that, so that's basically final wipe. There'll be the R32 release. There will be a a period of time, I think a month, possibly 2 months. Did you get out of a mirror? Where are you? There it is. Oh, it looked much nicer this time. Give items. 750 experience. How exciting. Yeah, so there'll be the full wipe. There'll be R32 release. Everybody will pick the houses. And then, after that's happened, the full game will launch. Or the full episode 1 will launch. Although, of course, development will be ongoing afterwards. Knife. Yes, I've got the knife. Oh, a dagger. Ah, so path of duty is still in active development. I should explore the path of love and find the guy standing somewhere by taking the boat under the bridge. In the meantime, kill some wolves. There's a wolf. Now you'll notice the text, the name is blue. So I'm breaking off my description of what's going on with releases to explain to you. Right. To explain to you that this blue text means this guy should be easily defeatable by me. So this is a new feature in this release. That's my first one. Green text means they're at least 10 levels lower than you, I think. I'm doing this from memory. Blue text means they're within 10 levels of you. Victory! Yay. And yellow text means they're 10 to 20 levels ahead of you, I think. And then red just means so far above you, you should hide. Let's see where we're going. Let's try a bit of Searing Ray this time. Now there is also a change in this release. I'm doing the free attack. That's the default. Yeah, seems to work for me. There is also a change in the release to reagents. Ooh, I've advanced something. So, field dressing, increased level 2. We all know how in there's an arrow up there, can you pick it up? You can. Cool. You all know how in previous releases, reagents, massively expensive. But you could cast the spells without using the reagents. Just a lower probability of success. In this release, and that's quite an interesting effect as well, isn't it? In this release, you need to have the reagents to cast the level 3 spells, like that fireball one I had there. You won't be able to cast any spells if you don't have... Oh look, it tells you about the boat. So this is what confused me the last time I did this. They took away the portals, but it wasn't obvious where the actual get out was. Anyway, yes, I was talking about reagents. I presume there's a boat under here somewhere. This is what I'm understanding. Is it on the other side? I have obviously misunderstood that somehow. Let's look in the journal. Anyway, yes, so underneath the Blood River Bridge. Reagents are quite expensive, but they weren't necessary. Although if you had them, you mostly use them up very quickly. In this release, the reagents are necessary. You won't be able to cast the level 3 spells without the reagents. But on the plus side, there's a much lower chance of actually using the reagents. I'm taking it this isn't the Blood River Bridge. So as long as you have a stock of reagents, they probably last you longer. So can anyone see a boat, is my question. Let's have a look on this bridge. Is it maybe on the other side of the river? So, I mean, this is all... there's a whole host of combat balance changes in this release. There's been quite a lot. Obviously, the previous two releases all came out early. That's not... Yeah, so they've had an extra week. An extra week to work on it. Presumably it's not this bridge then. I've looked on both sides. I'm not seeing a boat. Oh, is that the boat? Or is that just a log? It is a boat. And that is the boat. I don't know how that qualifies as being under the bridge, because the bridge is all the way over there. But nevertheless, that is the boat. Let's go. Okay, so the game crashed on me. I'll try to edit it so I don't get cut off in mid-word. In the meantime, I'm now in SotA, because the Truth questline isn't yet complete. Let's see if it... Nope. It did not record anything that I said as a result of the crash. Oh, feel free to correct me by saying my name is. There we go. Was I supposed to give him Edward's note and Silas Bridge? Yes. Look at that amazing amount of experience. Help. Yeah, blah, 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 assistance. Courier, he says. For Captain Cudgel. Right. So I've picked up that quest. And I've missed the box when I clicked on it. Goodbye. Thank you. Stay safe. Right. Interesting purple window through there. I don't think it's supposed to be that colour. Now obviously with the Unity engine upgrade, I think it's still a beta release of the engine, which should give us better performance, but also Unix specs and defects like we've seen already. I'm just going to head into town here. Hey, Raw Navigator, and you can see he's yellow, so that means he's at least 10 levels, 20 levels above me. He's yellow, I think. Not sure of the exact details. Owner. All of the lots in SotA are already taken. Anyway, let's get some mail. Selania. Well, I'm not going to go there right now anyway. I'm going to go to head off to Ardris and see if all the lots have been taken yet. Them purple windows. I don't think they're supposed to be purple. Hey. Chasm Phoenix Fire. So while I'm running, let's talk about some changes in combat. We might see some combat if I get pulled into a scene on the way to Ardris. We don't know. So the levels thing with colour of the text above the creature is one of the improvements you've already seen. There's a whole bunch of balancing. One of the most significant changes from my point of view is that the pet resurrect and heal skills now also work on players, so you don't need to train up resurrect in the life tree if you have resurrect the pet tree. The human, the life resurrect will be far more effective than the pet resurrect when used on humans, but it should make it work, I'm guessing. Right, so let's head to Ardris and see if all the houses have been taken yet. Let's head to Ardris, which is that way. It looks strangely bright, doesn't it? I wonder if I was just playing in winter the last time. Anyway, let's avoid him. And I talked about the changes in Magic to the use of reagents, which will be interesting. I've only got the few skills in it. I'm more interested in purple highlights there. Let's see if this crashes. Amazingly not. As I said, Heal and Resurrect work. There's a change to the way you get consumables if you're an archer. I'm not an archer, so that's by the by, but if you try to be an archer in previous releases, buying arrows at 2 gold apiece was a serious crimp on the way that worked. Very expensive to get started as an archer. In this release, arrows are bunched into quivers, and you buy the quiver, so that individual arrows cost less than 1 gold piece each. There's no other way of doing that, really. You can't have anything. There's no fractional gold pieces in Shroud of the Avatar. But that should be a good improvement. There are some changes to the way the combat works as far as targeting. So I've not used it really much before, but you can do these sort of manual charged attacks by holding the mouse button down. And the way they work now is different in that it will target the nearest enemy in the field of view at the point when you release the charge, not at the point where you start it. Oh, boink, 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 boink. Town Crier, tell me, how many lots are free? This could take a long time to load. So I'll probably try out an archery going with my secondary character, just to see how that goes. I will let you know. And then there's also a change to the way buffs work in combat. This could take a long time to load. Oh, he said down here, total in health, that's 49. City lots. Row lots available, 130. Well, I'll not wait for that to load because it'll take ages. Goodbye. Yeah, so I said goodbye. Say goodbye again. Let's see if I can escape this man. I can't escape. I've not got any mouse pointer. Where is my mouse pointer? Let's hit escape. There we go. That worked. Oh, I'm away now. Right. So first of all, I need to go to the bank to pick up my my deeds and stuff. More purple windows there. Oh, well, they're quite festive looking, really. They just don't look very natural. Anyway, let's head over here to the bank. So yeah, I was talking about the buffs and stuff. So previously, all the buffs more or less worked the same. Now, buffs from food are going to be much longer lasting, although the yeah, 2015 fireworks, Virtue Bowler Hat. I'm pretty sure that's this release's special reward, but never mind. Right, let's get my row lot deed. Let's get my Royal Elderberry seed. Let's get my basement. Royal recipe purple dye. Well, I bought some dye in the add-on store, but we'll not worry about that today. So I see this now. These are my pledge rewards. So instead of basically having all of the pledge rewards listed, I've just got one of them, three I've got. So what does that actually? Interesting. I'm still not sure how that works, to be honest with you. Immortality fruit seed. Let's get that out. We'll not worry about any of the armour for now. We'll go and look for some combat in a minute. Let's have my chest mimic, because I like him. Oh, my dark elven kinsman buckler. So that's a crossover item with the Ultimate Underworld game. Buckets of water. I need some buckets of water. Oh, there's my other house. There we go. Oh, there's the artisan tool reward. So before I got all of the artisan tools. So I'll leave that there for now. I know, because I've moved it, it's now in Ardoris, so we might as well get it out. Let's get the box of plenty out. There's no point getting anything else at the minute. I'll get my prosperity items. There's another founder artisan tool. Right, so because I'm at the two levels, I get two of these. I think I understand. But what I'm not quite sure about. Oh, do I need the hoe as well for the? Let's just take the. Oh no, too much. Let's leave the water there for now. Is how I now. How do I now select what type of thing it'll be? I'm not sure. Anyway, let's go and see if there's any houses available. Past the purple windows. Now, I've previously been away over. Way over towards the docks. What I want to do is be a bit closer to this crafting pavilion. What I don't know is if any of these will be free. There's a guard there. Let's have a look. Yep, so claimed. It expires in 119 days. 120 days. Yeah, so everyone's beating me to it. I imagine this is what the claiming process is going to be like. Oh, Carabrate. Someone seen on the forums a lot. So I'm guessing my chances of getting one of these handily located houses is quite slim. But, you know, it was worth checking out. Let's see what's around the corner here. All these purple windows. What can you say? Yeah. Oh, this one looks free. Click the deeds button. Claim current lot. Claim. I've claimed this lot. Woohoo! Okay. Unclaimed lot. Tax debt. Right, so it's not taxed. But now I can write. I want to put that one on. There we go. Yes. Okay. Looks good. So my next thing is, so a change in this release is that plants won't grow inside anymore. So that means, I'm guessing, I need to put it outside. Although I'm not sure, if I've not got a garden, if I can even do that. Doesn't look like it, does it? So if I put it here... No, I can't put it there. But if I stand inside, can I put it outside? No. 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 Well, we'll just have to work out how to do that at a later date. Let's see, the windows look fine from this side. Although, you know, I'm lacking actual windows, mysteriously. But we'll leave it there. So yes, I was talking about the different types of buff. Let's shut my door. Shut my door. There we go. Shut my door. Also, like the different. So food will be slower to consume, but much longer lasting. But you won't be able to consume it during combat anymore. Magical buffs and everything, the usual things, will be a lot slower, a lot faster to cast, but will end really quickly. So while I'm here talking about combat, let's have a look at public render. So a new feature here, someone's already collected all of the tin and nickel, look at them. You can now place orders with vendors, so that if someone then comes along and adds something to a vendor that's ordered, you'll immediately sell it. So let's just see if there's a... So I've got a spare house. Basement. I might be able to sell my house that I'm not using, but no. For immediate cash. We'll not worry about it now though. Rhinestone timber, 5-story basement. Oh, maybe I didn't get the other house out. Never mind. Carrying on. So, placing all the vendors, that's quite a neat new effect. Let's go and look for something to actually fight, shall we? There are some crafting changes. I mean, while I'm standing here by the crafting pavilion, there's a whole bunch of new recipes, including epic and augmented materials. So previously you could buy epic plate armour and you could buy augmented plate armour, but you couldn't straight up craft it, or, you know, not directly. I think it was a critical chance or something, perhaps. But now you can craft augmented plate and augmented cloth and build things out of it, which is makes it more interesting. So I understand the underlying crafting systems have now been fully implemented, and it's just a case of adding in all the recipes and stuff. I'm going to head on out and see if it doesn't crash. So I'm out. Let's head to a beginner area. Or maybe I'll get pulled into a scene. Oh, I do need to go around and deliver that mail, don't I? Let's head in that general direction then. I don't think I'll try the Tower of the Shattered Hour at this point. Wander around here. So while I'm actually, let's equip some stuff. Equipment. Let's equip my dark elven Kinsen booklet, and let's equip my taming call. And let's have a quick butchers at the skills, because I will want to summon my pet. There we go. While I'm in here, we can have a quick look at the fire tree. So you see that requires reagents. And even though I cast a fireball earlier, I've still got the full set of starter reagents remaining, which is always handy. Not using them. So let's head into the Celestial Westlands and see if there's something to fight, shall we? So here I am in the Westlands. Let's summon my pet. Hey, my skill increased. One thing you'll notice is that the summoning creature is down from an hour to 15 minutes, which will make life a bit easier. You no longer have to kill yourself just to get the pet back. Yeah, that behaviour is annoying though, isn't it? Keeps teleporting in front of me and slowing me down. Alright, I'm going to switch to auto attack mode. Oh, maybe I'm not going to switch to auto attack mode, maybe that's changed. Sure where that stuff is. Can't eat it. Where are the bad guys? Ooh, there's a crocodile. Now he's yellow, so I should probably stay away. But still, let's just see. Run away from the crocodile. And he moves fast, don't he? And let him burn. Hey, we killed the crocodile. Let's try harvesting him. So I don't know if it was much smoother. Definitely the performance is a lot cleaner. And I wasn't. Ooh! And it worked. And I wasn't accidentally targeting my pet throughout the combat because of that weird right click bug. Let's see if there's anything else. Anything else I can kill? Where's Chesty? There he is. can't see anything. So there is changes in this release to the spawning of mobs and stuff. So far that just seems to mean there's no monsters around. I'm sure that it'll get tuned. Usually these anything that's a bit weird can get fixed during the release. Ooh, weird green flashes. Weird red flashes. Glowing kinsman buckler. Now that's supposed to glow. Come on. It's supposed to glow if you've backed both this game and Underworld Ascendant. I don't know if that's really hooked up yet or whether everyone's just glowing. Well, we had some combat. Exciting as that was. While we're in combat mood, I should point out that it's now possible to dodge. Yeah, two actually cover that. Dodge magical attacks and block them. So I'm back on the map. Yes, I was saying I need to figure out there's the road. In this release, it's possible to dodge magic. I've not attempted it yet. I've not seen anyone dodge my magic yet. But it's also possible for magic spells to miss, especially if you're attacking higher level characters. If they're much higher level than you, then the magic has a pretty good chance of missing altogether. So, really, I'm just going to drop off the mail here, claim my 75 gold, and wrap up the video. There's a whole bunch of love them purple windows. The whole bunch of small improvements in this release. They are really gearing up for actually going live and stuff. I think rather than adding massive new features. It's quite pretty. Many of which it's not going to be possible to demo. It's not going to be possible to demo until I'm a much higher level, so I've not really gone into them. Several of them I just don't really understand how they work at the moment. Hey, Matt. So until I've tried them, can't really do anything. Let's just go into the vendor here and see, because there is one more interesting thing about crafted goods, if anybody's got any. No one comes here, obviously. And that it should now be possible as you, let's try the weapons merchant, as you mouse over things that are for sale. Fishmonger. Bank. Weapon merchant. You. Tanya. There we go. Yeah. She's got a whole lot of recipes, which is interesting. There you go, a bundle of 24 arrows. Price 2. So that's a factor of 24. Let's just look at equipment and see if she's got anything. Right, so it's only crafted items that show this stuff. I'm not sure how it'll work. I've still not figured out what I do with my... So what do I do with that? Double click on it. Ah, oh, here we go then. So I can have anything I want for my artisan tool reward. So let's, for now, let's just search. So what I really want for my artisan tool is something like a skinning knife, right? And then what I want for my founder artisan tool reward is, let's go for pickaxe. Interesting. So that's how that works. Glad we got that sorted out before the end of the video. I now only get one of each. I would love to have been able to plant my fruit seed, but I couldn't figure out. I couldn't figure out how to get the things to place. There may be a trick to it. It may be impossible. I don't know. So yeah, that's Shroud of the Avatar R26. It does feel faster to me. There are obviously some interesting rendering defects. But the performance definitely seems to be better than it was before. So if they can sort out the issues, this will all be quite promising, I think. 6 more releases. I should mention, this is the last release that's going to have a Grand Tour. No more Grand Tours after this. So this is your last chance to get a reward hat. There won't be another one. And yeah, Shroud of the Avatar 26, check it out.